I know things they don't know I know.
Have you ever wondered what it is exactly that gives Al Pacino a rare acting talent that seemingly nobody can argue with?
Me, I always tell the truth. Even when I lie.
Just how has he been able to mesmerize audiences so consistently for decades? Well, wonder no more. This video will break down four specific traits that give Pacino his signature edge. Also, we would love to know your favorite Pacino performance, especially if it's one that isn't mentioned here. Let us know in the comments below.
I've been around, you know. There was a time I could see, and I have seen. Boys like these, younger than these, their arms torn out, their legs ripped off. But there is nothing like the sight of an amputated spirit. There is no prosthetic for that.
Usually, the first sign of a great actor is how easy they make it look.
It's going to have a psychological effect on how the audience perceives you.
Pacino fits into all of his characters like a glove.
This is what it comes to.
It always feels genuine and never forced. Whether he's playing a gangster, a bank robber, a cop, or an everyday businessman.
I slice like a goddamn hammer.
His natural charisma makes it almost impossible to find a role where he's miscast. And this is because Al Pacino not only pretends to be his characters, he finds himself within each one of them. Even though he is most often quoted from scenes like these,
"Say hello to my little friend!"
Pacino's a master at building his characters from the inside out, by establishing clear motivations.
I swear I'll make it up to you, Al. I'm gonna change.
And harnessing sensitivity and nuance whenever possible.
I want you to marry me. I want you to be the mother of my children.
How's the baby?
He rose to fame during the period of cinema in the 1970s called New Hollywood. This was a point in filmmaking where the tropes of the obvious good guy found in older John Wayne movies were waning in popularity.
No, don't kill me, please.
Oh, I won't kill you.
Oh, Christ, thank you.
Get off.
No. Shoot that piece of chip.
No.
With the changing nature of the world during and after the Vietnam War, audiences, especially in America, began to identify with and relate to characters that no longer cleanly fit into the binary of good or evil. Hence, Pacino's classic characters are iconoclasts who don't rely on cliché and caricature, but rather empathy and understanding for the morally ambiguous and misunderstood.
I did what I could, Kay, to protect all of you from the horrors of this world.
But you became my horror.
The first major example we have of this is Pacino's breakout performance as Michael Corleone in The Godfather, who starts out from the beginning as just a convincing average Joe family man.
That's my family, Kay. It's not me.
But is pushed into the role of mafia boss, all in order to protect his family. He's a violent character, but his ruthlessness is born out of love and loyalty.
Don't tell me you're innocent, because it insults my intelligence. It makes me very angry.
Then there's Tony Montana, aka Scarface, a Cuban immigrant who perhaps has less than humble ambitions. Scarface is a story of the darker side of the American dream when taken to its most extreme conclusions. These characters may often be misguided, but they're never cartoonishly evil and are often more relatable to the average audience than the major protagonists of previous generations. No matter how natural some skills may appear to the outside world, most of the work is done behind the scenes, often being a culmination of years, even decades of work.
I guess I'm a workaholic.
Like many great screen actors throughout film history, Pacino began on stage and was heavily influenced by the tragic roles of William Shakespeare, especially in his case, that of Richard III. It's very likely that Pacino was attracted to and played out his most famous roles through the lens of a deep understanding of Shakespeare and other classic melodramas of the stage.
Get out of here!
Get on with your life, would you?
What life? I got no life! I'm in the dark here! Do you understand? I'm in the dark!
Pacino exhibits tremendous dynamic and unpredictability in nearly all of his performances, meaning he can play calm, soft-spoken roles, which can still erupt at any moment into erratic anger.
You're not listening to me!
Kay had a miscarriage, she lost the baby. Was it a boy?
Mike, you have 3.5 months.
Now, can't you give me a straight answer anymore? Was it a boy?
In short, Pacino's most memorable works tend to showcase him as a ticking time bomb. Later in his career, particularly after Scarface, Pacino became more commonly known for the more bombastic side of his acting dynamic.
Hoo-ah! Ping, pow, zoom, zoom.
However, in Martin Scorsese's The Irishman, Pacino is showcasing a return type of performance that gave him his original fame almost 50 years ago. Surprisingly, this is the first time the acclaimed director has ever worked with Pacino. Scorsese has always been a master at capturing some of the most provocative characters in modern gangster cinema, and this long overdue pairing has given Pacino a chance to flex his greatest acting muscles once again.
Well, that's good. That makes me feel good. Oh, I can breathe.
Many actors, as they grow into their older years, often settle for Hollywood typecasting. But with roles such as this, Pacino has proven that he's still as sharp as ever, and reminds us yet again why he's such an iconic American actor.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.